Lewis structure's giving you trouble? Let's fix that fast with my 5-step method. Step 1. Count the valence electrons. This periodic table here is your key resource. Group 1 here, 1 valence electron. Group 2, those have 2. Skip the transition metals, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So for something like HF, hydrogen, fluorine, 1 plus 7 is 8. 8 valence electrons for the HF molecule. Now pause and give this one a try. And remember, we have 4 of these chlorine atoms, so that's going to be 4 times 7. That's this right here. Okay, on to step 2. We need to choose the atom that goes in the center of our structure. For HF, it's just 2 atoms, so there's no center. Don't need to worry about that. But for something like CCl4, there will be a center. The way to remember this, fluorine is the most electronegative. So when we move away, atoms become less electronegative. Chlorine, that's right next to fluorine, pretty electronegative, and then carbon over here. So our Lewis structure will look like this, where carbon's the furthest away from fluorine, so we put it at the center. And note these lines, they represent pairs of electrons that are bonded between the atoms there. Okay, one thing to watch out for though, hydrogen atoms always go on the outside. So for something like CH4, we'll put the hydrogens around the carbon. Hydrogen atoms always go on the outside. So give this one a try. H2S. So remember, hydrogen is always on the outside. We end up with something like this. Okay, step 3. We start by putting a pair of electrons between atoms. That's the chemical bond. So we put our pair of electrons there, and that's where we start. Sometimes you'll see the pair of electrons written as a line. That line represents a pair of electrons in a chemical bond between atoms. So if we had CH4, both of these are correct. But remember, we counted the valence electrons up, and we need to be careful we're only using the exact number we counted. So step 4, we're going to complete the octet on the outside atoms. We're going to fill their outer shells. So we counted that we had 8 valence electrons. We used 2 to form the chemical bond. And here's an important rule, hydrogen again. Hydrogen only needs 2 valence electrons to get its outer shell full. Almost all of the other atoms you come across, the octet means 8. So hydrogen has 2, that's good. For fluorine, we're going to put 8 electrons around the fluorine. We've used all 8, 2, 4, 6, 8. Hydrogen has 2, we're good. Fluorine has 8. That's the correct Lewis structure for HF. Okay, now pause, give this one a try. And for H2S, we have a total of 8 valence electrons. So draw that Lewis structure. You should end up with something like this. Pairs of electrons between atoms, chemical bond. Hydrogen has 2, it's good. And then that sulfur in the center, it has 8. That's the correct Lewis structure for H2S. So try these. And both of them have a total of 8 valence electrons. So you should have ended up with where each hydrogen has 2 valence electrons. The central atoms have 8, an octet, and we used all 8 valence electrons in our Lewis structure. No more, no less. Okay, here's a problem we run into though sometimes, and it's real important. O2, oxygen gas, it has 12 valence electrons. So you might draw the structure something like this. We've used 12 valence electrons. This oxygen has an octet. This oxygen only has 6, and we just can't add more electrons. We only have 12. Here's what we do. We're going to take this pair of electrons and move it to the center. We're still using 12 valence electrons, but now we have 8 here, and we have 8 here. An octet for both oxygens? We're done. That's the Lewis structure. And if you like symmetry, you could do that. And we could also represent this by drawing two lines to represent these two pair of valence electrons. All right, so now you try one. N2, we have 10 valence electrons. And to give you a hint, you probably need a triple bond. So you can see the problem, and here's how we can solve it. Still using 10 valence electrons, octet, octet. We're good with that triple bond. And you could even write it like this right here if you wanted to. Now you've got the core ideas. Time for some practice. Jump over to the practice video or maybe look at some of the exceptions like hydrogen that you find in doing Lewis structures. It's Dr. B. Thanks for watching.